Hey guys. Today I thought I would do a video talking all about my favorite low light tolerating hanging houseplants. I love me a good hanging plant. There's just something about hanging plants that I like extra love even more than regular plants that sit in little pots, you know? I don't know why. Anyone else, do you get me? Let me know if you understand what I'm trying to say. And when I say low light plants, I don't mean they thrive or love low light, I mean they tolerate it. Just because a plant tolerates low light doesn't mean that that's its ideal environment. And you may notice like some slower growth, a little bit smaller growth, depending on the amount of low light you're giving it. And you might notice that the care you have to give the plant is a little bit different than if you were to keep the plant in high light, of course. So like mainly I'm talking about watering. So if you keep a plant in low light, just keep in mind you will most likely have to water that plant less frequently, or you could end up with rot or things like that. Just keep that in mind. As always, it's very helpful if you're able to watch this video all the way through and maybe click on to another video. It's very helpful for my channel. Please thumbs up or thumbs down this video, letting me know if you like this type of content, and leave a comment down below telling me some of your favorite low light hanging plants, or I guess just hanging plants in general. Okay, let's get into it. Since it's right here, it was in the backdrop of my intro shot. We're gonna talk about Philodendron Brazil, which this is my Philodendron Brazil plant. I think this is just such a beautiful plant. And as for care for this puppy, especially in low light, I only water it by like filling the leaves. If they start, you can kind of see this one's a little bit veiny and like thin. If it starts to feel kind of papery, thin like that, then I will go ahead and water. It's really easy to take care of even in low light. And I love the fact that even in low light, this one does end up getting like such beautiful color. The only lighting this plant here gets is from a north window. Really, really pretty, full looking, beautiful, beautiful plant. What do you think of the Philodendron Brazil? This is my Neon Pothos. I find this to be a very easy plant. And again, like the Brazil, this is one I actually find prefers lower light because this one does bleach super easily in my experience. Let me know if you have a different experience, but I love that the leaves grow in. I find them to grow in a lot bigger than my even Golden Pothos. So I love that. The shape is a little bit different of the leaves than the Golden Pothos too. You can kind of see. I hardly ever water this thing and it is just fine and it has grown a lot. But my favorite thing about it is super, super vocal, and like you don't even have to fill the leaves on the plant to know it needs water. Like you'll just look at the plant and you'll be able to tell it needs water because it gets all droopy. Thank you for telling me what you need, little Neon Pothos. And I think it's a really beautiful hanging plant. Like I love how this is draping down the side. This isn't really in a hanging pot, but it's super pretty in a hanging pot. A big old thank you to the sponsor of today's video, Ritual. And here's a little bit more about them. Something I'm personally very conscious of is the fact that even with a very healthy diet, it can be difficult to get important nutrients into our daily diet. But on that same note, I've been kind of hesitant of multivitamins, mostly because there are just so many things on the market. And I'm someone that definitely likes to take a more simplified approach to things, which is why I really trust Ritual. Ritual has decluttered the multivitamin, making sure that their vitamins can contain only nutrients that are hard to get into a regular diet. Ritual is also vegan friendly, sugar free, non-GMO, and allergen free, which is awesome. Something else I really respect Ritual for is their transparency on their ingredients and where they're sourced from. Plus their bottles are made with 100% recycled materials. This is a delivered to your door subscription. With Ritual, it's only $1 a day to have 9 high quality nutrients that are hard to get from your diet alone. Better health doesn't happen overnight, but Ritual is offering all of you 10% off your first 3 months. That's 10% off during your first 3 months by going to my link and using this code at checkout. Again, that information will be at the top of my description box. Thank you so much, Ritual. Let's get back into the video. And I should say that all of the plants I'm talking about today, I don't have necessarily hanging. Some of them I just have draping over edges and stuff, but they are still plants that I think are really beautiful as hanging plants. I've either had them hanging in the past, or I would love to hang them out of my ceiling right now, but Ryan doesn't want to put any more holes in our ceiling. You know, the struggle. Yeah, okay. Next up is Philodendron Micans, which again, I guess all of these plants actually tend to prefer a little bit lower light. I used to have this in like right next to a north window, which is still pretty low light, and the leaves just were kind of, I guess they were bleaching and I don't see any doing it right now. They were burning. So yeah, and now that I've moved it even farther back from a north window, it's done so much better and looks so much more velvety. Like, I think you'll be able to pick that up. See that? And it grows a lot faster here. I think it's such a beautiful, beautiful hanging plant, you guys. This is definitely top three hanging plants for me, and I love it. I just think it's so beautiful. Super dark, dark foliage, and I will say this is one of the low light hanging plants that out of all the plants I'm gonna talk about in this video, this is definitely one of the plants that need watered more frequently, even in lower light, especially if you want it to get the sheen. I probably water this plant every 5-6 days, at least once a week, sometimes more than once a week. I'm actually going to go ahead and water it because it's looking a little bit droopy over here. Philodendron micans. Okay, so this is kind of one of the more unique hanging plants that I love. I think it's kind of a more unique one anyway. I just don't see very many people utilizing these as hanging plants. I actually think I'm gonna move this one into my hanging pot in the bathroom, which you'll see in a minute where my Adansonia is. This is a lemon lime Maranta. It's one of my top favorite plants of all time. All of this kind of Maranta Leuconura varieties I think look really beautiful as hanging plants because, as you know, they're called prayer plants because their leaves like fold up and move. So it's just really cool to be able to, I don't know, I think you can notice the movements more when it is a hanging plant, and it just has a lot of a different shape than most of the hanging plants. Like the other ones I've showed you, you saw them, but they're more like trailers. They dangle. This one just like poofs out everywhere and kind of does a zigzaggy looking thing. I think this one is a really, really cool one to have as a hanging plant. Let me know if any of you hang your Maranta plants also. I'm very interested to hear if anybody else does that. And by also, I mean at all, because I don't have mine as a hanging plant, although I do think I'm going to switch it up. And these definitely like low light. They like bright indirect light as well, but this has been sitting, I think it's about 8 feet pulled back from a north window, and it has been fine. I mean, you can see it's a big plant. There's some new leaf there, a new leaf there, new leaf there, new leaf there, there, oh, here, kind of everywhere. So yeah, I think it's happy, and I only water this one. This is another one just like the Neon Pothos that is very vocal about when it needs watered. So you'll notice a definite droop when it's thirsty. But if you're kind of in doubt, you can just feel the soil. If the soil feels really dry, like if you stick your finger in and no soil is stuck on your finger, then that means it probably needs some water. So yeah, but it's very forgiving as long as you just don't wait too long after it starts to droop. It's very forgiving about being underwatered or neglected for a little while, which is why I love this. So Lemon Lime Maranta. I'm breathing so hard. Okay, this one is a little bit thirsty, actually a lot of it thirsty, so ignore how curled the leaves are on this, but this, you guys, I've talked about it in so many videos. Do I even need to say anything? Scenapsis Pictus Exotica. I've already said everything I feel like in all of my other videos that can be said about this plant, but low light, very easy, vocal, how it has the curling leaves, super striking and beautiful, and can tolerate a lot of different lights. So, and I find it to grow really quickly, although I've said that before in a video, and I know a lot of other people are like, mine grows so slow. Most often it seems like people are saying that when they have like a very small plant, which mine started out very small. It seems like small, super small, like new plants, propagations, baby plants tend to grow a little bit slower, and then as they mature and get more leaf and especially root growth, it will start to grow faster. So if you're finding your Scindapsis plant to be slow growing, then you'll probably just have to wait it out. Unfortunately, for those of us that are impatient and just want some growth really quickly, just wait it out. All right, so yeah, Scindapsis Pictus Exotica. I couldn't leave it out, even though I know it's probably annoying how much I talk about this plant. Let me know if you have this plant and you agree with me. Okay, so again, ignore how sad this plant looks. It's actually kind of a sad story. I had this draping off of my windowsill, which you're right in front of right now. And my dog hit it with this tail and it knocked over and everything spilled out. So is some dead foliage down there that got crushed and then roots broke off and stuff. Anyway, I'm kind of going on a tangent now. This is a white butterfly syngonium, but I do think syngoniums in general are really beautiful hanging plants, kind of like with the Maranta. It's just a much different shape than most of the like trailing hanging plants we see. I mean, like, what's this doing? I should have cut all this growth off for the video, but you know what? This is
Ooh, that scared me. I thought I saw a scale, but it was a piece of dirt.
What was I saying?
Oh, different shapes. So yeah, it is a lot of different shape. And this one's kind of cool because a lot of other like hanging trailing plants, most of the other ones I've talked about, like again, they grow downward. This one kind of grows downward and then it'll like reach and go kind of all over the place. And I just love the way these leaves like bounce around. I don't know if that's like a logical reason to have this as one of my favorite hanging plants, but it is to me in my own noggin. So then how you'll know this needs to be watered is when, like down here, you can see these two leaves are kind of drooping away from the rest of the leaves. And yeah, that's how I can tell that the plant needs watered. So like bulk of the plant is standing up super erect, but these little puppies down here are starting to droop. So maybe once a few more leaves droop like that, I'm gonna go ahead and water it. Actually, I'm probably going to water it now. It needs some water after all it has been through. Again, I don't really have it in a hanging plant, but kinda. Well, it's kinda hanging. It's hanging a little bit. Okay, onward.
So now we're in my bathroom, so I know it's gonna be a little bit echoey. I'm sorry, but I'm just gonna throw in a heartleaf philodendron really quick, of course. I think this is a beautiful plant. Again, with philodendron Brazil, like I love the growth pattern. It is a little bit more of like a simple looking plant, but I personally love that. And I do like how, even though it's green, like the new growth comes in kind of golden, a little bit pinkish. It does grow in very, very full, very quickly, and it's super low maintenance. Like I only water this once every like 10 days-ish, and it does fine. So yeah, just kind of whenever I remember, I go ahead and do it. And this is almost probably 12 feet pulled back from a north window, and it is love and life. I think it's love and life. Looks like it's love and life because it has grown a lot actually since I put it here. Thought I'd throw that one in there, even though it's kind of a basic one that a lot of people talk about. I don't know, is that okay of me to do? All right, yeah, heartleaf philodendron. While we're here in my bathroom, I'm just gonna go ahead and tell you, this is another Maranta I would think would look really, really cool as a hanging plant. So this is a Macoyana. And why I think this one would be cool is, okay, get this, during the day, the leaves fold open. So like as it's hanging, you'd be able to see the tops of the leaves, well, some of them, but when it folds up, like you'll be able to see the beautiful purple bottom leaves. I don't know, I just think it'd be really cool, like contrast, looks a lot different than a lot of other plants. Super cool coloring, and again, tolerates low light, which we love. Thank you. And I do actually find this to be one of the easiest Calathea varieties I've ever experienced anyway. So yeah, Calathea Macoyana. One more close up of the beautiful purple underside. Right? Am I right? Yeah, I think I'm right. Let me know. This is a Monstera Adansonii. It is the wide form, I think is what it's called. I love this as a hanging plant. I mean, it's kind of weird looking, but I like that. Like, what is it doing? These leaves look kind of sad. I think it needs watered. Like you can see, it's so weird looking. This is one that in terms of low light, it needs to be at like the higher end of low light. So I do have it just right next to my north window. And yeah, it's done fine here. I mean, you can see it's growing, and this is actually the spot I think I'm going to put my lemon lime Maranta at and then move this down into my grow tent actually, because I just think it's getting a little bit big to be a hanging plant, especially above where I sit in the tub when I soak, because I don't want this falling off onto my head. Are you kidding me? The holes in the leaves again are just like different in terms of a hanging plant. Like, I don't know, I like a lot of variety in my plants, and that's some variety. Look, my finger is poking through the plant. How many plants can you say that for? Monstera Adansonii, and again, this is a little bit thirstier of a low light hanging plant. So this is out of all of my like low light tolerating plants. This is the one I probably water the most out of the bunch. So just keep that in mind. Okay, and I think we're gonna be a little bit backlit here, but last plant I have to mention, this is another super basic common one like everybody already knows about, but I feel like I couldn't do this video without talking about this one. And it's Golden Pothos, of course. So easy, basically, however you wanna care for this plant, I think it would do fine in my experience. Anyway, really pretty, cool variegation, cute, hangy, grows fast, fun. Yeah, Golden Pothos, couldn't leave it out. Just gonna throw it in there really quick. All right, so that's the last plant of this video.
So those are all the plants I'm going to talk about in today's video. Let me know if there are others that you feel should have made the list that I maybe forgot about or didn't think of, because this brain only works so fast. So let me know. Yeah, that is it for this video. Thank you so much for watching, and I will see you in my next one.